Good afternoon, everyone. At the outset, I would like to thank Professor Tiwari and Professor Baldev Raj to invite me to give me an opportunity to present my work in this forum. I'll be talking about the innovations and the translational research, and out of a host of problems that we have solved and developed the technology, I'll be highlighting two technologies. One is for the water treatment, that is for removal arsenic from the drinking water. Mm. And second one is the ultra low cost hollow fibers. And it has tremendous implication in the food processing unit, juice processing industry, as well as the healthcare units in the form of hemodialysis fibers. The laterite based filter that we have developed for the arsenic removal, the major property of the laterite is basically naturally occurring soil. It is red in color. It has a huge amount of iron and aluminium hydroxides. Because of the presence of these components, it is a very good adsorbent for the arsenic, both forms of arsenic, arsenic 3 and arsenic 5. And after chemical treatment, so its capacity, adsorption capacity increases several folds, around 33 milligram per gram, which is one of the highest of the naturally occurring material that goes for the that can adsorb arsenic. Now this filter we have designed so that it can remove arsenic, iron and microorganism in one shot. And this filter can be designed of up to any capacity, ranging from the domestic unit from 40 to 100 liter per day capacity to 50,000 liter per day capacity for the community scale filter. And the salient, it has some striking features are, it has a very long life, 5 to 7 years. And during its lifetime, there is no regeneration is required. So that makes the filter, the maintenance of the filter pretty simple. And the major point is that spent material, which is, after its life is over, this satisfies the toxicology leaching protocol. That means it can be, disposed of very easily without having a proper disposal, protocol or protocol. So now if we really talk about the domestic filters, it does not require any electricity. So it's a simple solution for the rural community without doing any proper maintenance. The filter can go on operating for 5 to 7 years without any problem. I'll be showing you data for four years. And if you really do the economics, it turns out to be that the 2 paisa per liter of the filtered water, which will be devoid of arsenic, iron and microorganism. So some of the filters, I'll be showing. So one is in, it is deployed in 2012. These projects are basically funded by UNICEF and Department of Science and Technology. So that is a 500 liter per day capacity filter. In Kashinathpur Free Primary School, it was deployed in 2012, October. And there is the midday meal ladies, they collect the water for the cooking of the midday meals for the children. The children drink water. The 300 liter per day is earmarked for the students. Rest 200 liter is distributed. There is a tap outside of the school. So 200 liter is distributed among the villagers. Then another filter is deployed in northwest Bengal. It's a very arsenic prone area in Malda district. That is around 800,000 liter per day capacity. Another school in girls school in 2012, it was deployed. So it is 2000 liter per day capacity. And recently, this filter has been installed in one of the affected areas in Barasat, which is a very huge capacity, 2000 liter per hour. So this technology has been transferred to two companies. The first one is from Jharkhand. It has already got an order of 4 crores from the state of Jharkhand to install several community-based filters. And second one is in Calcutta, in Howrah West, and it is already awarded two crores of worth contract from Public Health Engineering Department of West Bengal. In this slide, I will just present a data of 4 years data. If you look into this figure, the day one is 2012 October, and last date is April 2016. The black dots are basically the free concentration of arsenic, and it varies from 50 to 200. 50 milligram microgram per liter. So the permissible level of WHO is 10 microgram per liter. There is a variation of seasonal variation during the rainy season. Because of dilution effect, the concentrated arsenic goes down. And during the summer time, it shoots up to 250 milligram microgram per liter. And the red dots, which are basically the output of our filtrate, and it's always less than 10 microgram per liter, confirming the approval limit, permissible level of WHO. Similarly, if you look into the iron, the concentration in the feed, it varies from anything from, let's say, 5 to 30 ppm, milligram per liter. It's pretty high in that area. So the permissible level for drinking water of iron is 0.3 milligram per liter, and it is hovering around that since last 4 years. And I didn't show the microorganism thing, it's zero. WHO limit is there should not be any coliform in the drinking water, and it is conforming to that. The next one I'll be talking about the spinning of ultra low cost hollow fibers. Hollow fiber is basically a very thin fiber with a porous wall, and this is generally utilized for the different membrane separation processes. And the basic the module for the most popular module for any membrane based process is the hollow fiber cartridge, because it is directly scalable and one can have very low volume, very high surface area, filtration area in a very low volume. Therefore, the design of the cartridge becomes very compact. So that's why the hollow fibers are basically very useful, and it's becoming more popular in various industries, starting from the food processing, water filtration, up to dialysis. And don't just believe me that 99% of membrane operation, apart from reverse osmosis and nanofiltration, 95% is because of the dialysis. The hemodialysis fibers are the major market market leaders for the hollow fibers. Now, the hollow fibers is generally spun. The preparation of the hollow fibers, we call it spinning of the fibers. It is basically based on the process of extrusion. And the spinning unit is called, the heart of the spinning unit is called a spinneret. The total cost of the hollow fiber spinning unit is around 1.25 crores currently. The heart of the spinning unit is called a spinneret. It is nothing but an extruder. It contains two coaxial syringes. In middle syringe, we flow water, and which is basically anti-solvent for a polymer. And the outer syringe, the annular space, the polymer solution, which is dissolved in a solvent, typically any non-aqueous solvent like DMF, chloroform, acetone. So whenever the water that is pushed through the inner syringe, it comes in contact with the polymer solution. Since it is an anti-solvent for the polymer solidifies, forming the hollow core inside the hollow fiber, and that core runs along the length of the fiber and in preparing the hollow fibers. And typically the dimension of the hollow fibers are around 500 to 600 micron for water treatment problems. And what we did, we just replaced the typical spinneret cost around $50,000. Good Japanese spinner. So that is the most expensive part of the hollow fiber spinning unit. So whatever we did, we took two disposable syringes and made a special arrangement so that we can have that extrusion assembly, and thereby we are basically replacing a $50,000 assembly by a 20 rupees assembly. That is the order of reduction of the processing cost that we are talking about here. So by selecting in this slide I have shown different types of hollow fibers for different applications. By selecting the starting polymer, using the additives, by tinkering the operating conditions, you can have fibers with different porosities for different applications, starting from microfiltration hollow fiber. This is generally used for separation of the suspended materials and bacteria, 0.2 micron, then various grades of the ultrafiltration membranes, like polysulfone, which will be giving you an average pore size 64 angstrom. Then by controlling the surface chemistry, you can reduce the pore size to 57 angstrom, 42 angstrom, even less than that. Now, what are the applications? There are two applications I'll be talking about. One is the extraction of polyphenols, probably the Hindustan Liver guys who have presented in the morning. They're talking about the extraction of phytonutrients. So tea leaves, green tea leaves is the biggest source of polyphenol. And polyphenol basically a series of phenolic compounds, out of which there is a particular component called EGCG, epigalactocatechin gallate, which is the most active antioxidant and which will be having very high anti-cancerous activity. And it is also having anti-aging property. Therefore, it's highly used in pharmaceuticals as well as the skin care units. Now, we have developed a technology based on this for extraction of the polyphenol in a bulk scale, which will be in the purity of, let's say, around 75 to 80% of total polyphenol. In fact, there is market demand for different grades of polyphenol of different purity levels. So by this technology, we can have a large scale production to a tune of 50 tons per day, and that technology has been transferred to a company in Calcutta, Phytobiotech Private Limited, which is one of the pharmaceutical companies. And then the second one that we have developed from for cold sterilization of green coconut water. It's a very good sports drink because it contains lots of potassium and sodium salt. Okay, it's a very rich source, natural source of potassium. So therefore, any sports person who is having the physical exercise, he'll be rejuvenated once he drinks the coconut water. But this contains, if you put the coconut water in open for 15 minutes, it will be spoiled because of the microbial growth, because there are lots of cell debris and the proteins which will be the potent source for general growth of the microbes. So those will be separated by properly selection of membrane-based separation processes like microfiltration and ultrafiltration. And then one can, if you can just hook up with this, with the proper aseptic packaging, then it can be, you can have a long shelf life without adding any preservative, any additive, just keeping its nutritional quality intact. Okay. The next, I'll just take a couple of minutes for talking about the dialysis. That is the most important part of it. Now, for the dialysis patients, India is the capital of the diabetics, and we do not have our own, technology for spinning the hemodialysis fibers. The particular striking feature of the hemodialysis fiber is that it has a very small, diameter. It's basically ranging from 180 to 225 micron. It is hair thin fibers, hollow fibers with a particular pore size distribution, and thickness will be, the medical specification is that internal diameter is 220 micron and wall thickness is 30 to 40 micron. So there is a reason for that. I'm not going into detail of that. So we are basically importing fibers, cartridges from Germany, France, Korea and Japan. These four companies have the monopoly. The spinnerets are not available in the market. They are all proprietary items. And Fresenius, the German company, is the market leader. The cost of one Fresenius cartridge is basically around 2,200 rupees. Okay. So with this technology, this project is funded by Department of Science and Technology and its healthcare group. And we have developed this technology without compromising with our small, low cost technology, without compromising its quality. And if you look into this table, you can find out that it satisfies all the qualities. That is, the freshness is the earmark. And this is a pediatric dialysis prototype, and this is a comparison of F6 cartridge, the freshness cartridge. The lower one is basically developed by our laboratory. And this project has gone into the second phase for doing the animal trial. Then it will be going for the human trial. Then it will be getting the approval of the all, approval agencies like MCI and others. It will taking some time. So these two technologies I would like to talk about and highlight and showcase in this presentation. Thank you very much.